Hi students, all of you, good morning and good afternoon. Welcome to the class. In this class, we are going to discuss today's KSET model examination conducted by us. The chapter is Structure of Atom. And now we are seeing the question number 44. Which of the following sets of quantum numbers is not allowed? Quantum numbers. How many quantum numbers we know? We know 4 quantum numbers. The first one is principal quantum number. What is the symbol of principal quantum number? Small n. Second one is azimuthal quantum number. Azimuthal quantum number is represented by small l. Third one is magnetic quantum number. Magnetic quantum number is represented by small m. And the last one is spin quantum number. So to know about the complete information of an electron in an atom, we require 4 quantum numbers. The fourth one is spin quantum number, represented by small s. Otherwise, it is represented by ms. Here, magnetic quantum number is represented by ml or small m. Right. All of us know the azimuthal quantum number depends upon principal quantum number. Small l value depends upon small n value. And azimuthal quantum number values are always the azimuthal quantum number values are always less than principal quantum number. Yes, see the options. Question number 44. That is here question number 14 in my paper. If you see the option B, what is the option B given? Option B given is small n is equal to 1, comma, small l is equal to 1, comma, small m is equal to 0. Actually, it is not the comma, semicolon. Here I am saying semicolon. S is equal to minus half. Yes, if you say this set of quantum numbers, n value, that is principal quantum number value, given as 1, small l value means azimuthal quantum number is given as 1. Whether it is correct? It is not correct. Why? Because means azimuthal quantum number values, that is small l value, must be lesser than small n value. Once again, the azimuthal quantum number value must be lesser than principal quantum number value. But in this set, azimuthal quantum number is given as 1, principal quantum number is given as 1. Here, what is happening? Small n becomes equal to small l. This is not a possible condition. So as a result, for the given question, the option is B. Yes, text me the next question number. What is the next question number? Because the chart is continuously moving, that's why I'm unable to see the remaining numbers. Once again, text me the number. Question number 30. Yes, question number 30. The number of radial nodes. Bharat, is it correct? The number of radial nodes. Bharat, respond. The number of radial nodes of 3s and 2p orbitals respectively. This is the question you are asking for. The answer? Right. The number of radial nodes. Yesterday also I explained the same. Bharata, then what is the question? What is the question you are asking? Last question. So in your examination paper, the last question Bharat is asking for answer. The electronic configuration of an element is 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, 4s1, 3d5. I am reading it as 4s1, 3d5. Otherwise, 3d5, 4s1. Yes, this is the electronic configuration of chromium. This is the electronic configuration of chromium in the ground state itself. there is no excitation is happened. Just the 4s electron, one of the 4s electron is jumped into 3d orbitals. We already discussed about abnormal electronic configuration of chromium and copper. Abnormal electronic configuration. Last question. Question number is the last one. Abnormal electronic configuration. Abnormal electronic configuration of chromium and copper are discussed. Here we are taking the chromium. Atomic number is 24. According to Afbau principle. According to Afbau principle, the electronic configuration is 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, 4s2, 3d4. This is according to Afbau principle. According to Afbau principle, this is the electronic configuration of chromium atom in the ground state. But to expect the stability, chromium is going to show some abnormality. One of the electron from 4s. Is jumping into 3D, then we can write the electronic configuration as 4s1 3d5. This is also the electronic configuration of chromium in the ground state. But among these two, which one is correct means? Yes, this is the correct electronic configuration. Why? Because means to expect stability, one of the electron from 4s is jumping into 3D. Then 4s2 becomes the 4s2 becomes 4s1, 3d4 becomes 3d5. If you say the 4s1, what we can understand? It is a half-filled orbital, And if we take the 3d subshell is having 5 orbitals. Each orbital is having 1 electron. That means this subshell is also half-filled. So this is the half-filled subshell or half-filled orbitals. And this is the half-filled subshell or half-filled orbital. So whenever atom is having empty orbitals or completely filled orbitals or half-filled orbitals, such atoms are going to be stable. So to expect the stability, one of the 4s electron of chromium is jumping into 3D. Then the electronic configuration of chromium is written as 4s1 3d5. This is the correct electronic configuration of chromium in the ground state. Yes, text me the next question number. Text me your next question number. Question number 20, Bhuneshwari. Yes, text me. What is the starting of that question? Question number 20, Bhuneshwari. Okay, coming to you. The quantum numbers small n is equal to 2. Bhuneshwari, is it correct? The quantum numbers small n is equal to 2, small l is equal to 1. Yes, the quantum numbers small n is equal to 2, small l is equal to 1. Small n is equal to 2 means first shell. Small n is equal to 2 is indicating. Sorry. What is given here? Small n is equal to 2 is indicating second shell. Small l is equal to 1 is given here. We know l is equal to 0 means. S subshell or S orbitals. S subshell or that is indicating S orbitals. Small l is equal to 1 indicates P subshell or P orbitals. Here what is given? L is equal to 1 is given. So we can say that second shell and it is the P subshell. So the answer is 2P. 2P orbitals. Option C. Option C. Yes, text me the next question number. Question number 21, Ibrahim. Which of the following electronic configuration is not possible according to Hund's rule? Which of the following electronic configuration is not possible according to Hund's rule? Yes, okay, Ibrahim. Yes, first of all, we have to know the Hund's rule. What is meant by Hund's rule? If you understand the concept, you can solve these questions because these are not problematic. These are only conceptual questions. First, we have to know the Hund's rule. What is meant by Hund's rule? Hund's rule means, suppose when P subshell is taken, What is taken? P sub shell is taken. How many orbitals are there? 3 orbitals are there. One is the px orbital, second one is the py orbital, third one is the pz orbital. All these orbitals are having same energy and similar shapes, that is dumbbell shapes. This type of orbitals are called as degenerated orbitals. So what are meant by degenerated orbitals? The orbitals which are having same energy and similar shapes, or simply we can say that the orbitals which are having similar energies and shapes, the orbitals which are having similar energies and shapes, they are called as degenerated orbitals. Whenever, suppose we are going to take 4 electrons, how we have to fill the electrons? One electron is going to enter into first orbital, second electron is going to enter into next orbital, third electron is going to enter into next orbital. What is happening here? Filling of each degenerated orbital, filling of each degenerated orbital with one electron is taking place. Next, fourth electron is there. That fourth electron is going to be paired. So whenever more number of electrons are there and more number of degenerated orbitals are there, all the degenerated orbitals are first filled with one electron. Then only what is happening? Pairing of electrons is going to take place. So this is the concept of Hund's rule. Now coming to this question. In my paper, question number it is 21. Which of the following electronic configuration is not possible according to Hund's rule? Once again, the question. Which of the following electronic configuration is not possible according to Hund's rule? Yes, if you see that options, if you go for that option D is given as 1s2, 2s2, 2px2. Actually, 2p is going to contain 3 subshells. Px orbital, 2p subshell is going to contain 3 orbitals. What are the 3 orbitals? Px orbital, py orbital, and here it is pz orbital. The 2p subshell is containing 3 orbitals. One is the px orbital, second one is the py orbital, third one is the pz orbital. How we have to fill the electrons? Each orbital must be filled with one electron. Then only pairing is going to take place. Here we are having how many electrons? 2 electrons in p orbitals. That means we have to fill one electron in px orbital and then one electron in py orbital. Then what is going to be the electronic configuration? The electronic configuration is going to be 1s2, 2s2, 2px orbital is having one electron. 2px orbital is having one electron. 2py orbital is having one electron. 2py orbital is having one electron. 2pz orbital is having no electron. That is 2pz 0. 2pz 0. This is the correct electronic configuration and it is obeying the Hund's rule. Whereas, when the 2 electrons are written in the px orbital, when this electron is also written in the px orbital, this is not going to obey Hund's rule. Yes, this is your answer. Yes, are you understood? Please give your response fastly. Okay, fine. What is the next number? Bharat, respond. You got very less marks. Very less marks, Bharat. You have to respond. Question number 18. Okay. A completely filled d orbital. That is a D10. Yes, is it correct? Bharat. Okay, fine. Once again, the question. A completely filled d orbital, D10. D10 is going to have which type of configuration? Which type of shape? D10. So first of all, d-octals. How many d-octals are there? 5 d-octals are there. Dxy, dyz, dxz, dx square y square, dz square. Dxy, dyz, dxz, dx square y square, and dz square. First, when degenerated octals are there, that means when the same energetic octals are there, we have to fill one electron in each orbital. That is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So this is the complete configuration. What is this one? D10 configuration. D10 configuration. Right, see the options. Yes, what is the question number? Okay, 18. Option A, spherically symmetrical. Option B, has octahedral symmetry. Has tetrahedral symmetry, and D is given as depends upon the atom. Once again, the question, the completely filled D octals are, which type of octals they are? Which type of octals they are? In the last class about chromium and copper, if you watched that video, abnormal electronic configuration of chromium and copper, I explained that whenever the octals are going to have, suppose, see this one once again, for your easy understanding, 1, 2, 3, 4 electrons are taken. What is the configuration here? D4. It is not symmetrical because 4 octals are filled with 1 electron in each, 5th octal is vacant. This is unsymmetrical. If I write 1 electron here, now I can say that D5. Which type of electronic configuration it is? Symmetrical electronic configuration. Symmetrical. Because each orbital is filled with one electron. Like that, when we take D10 configuration, each orbital is filled with two electrons. So there is a symmetry in the arrangement of electrons. See the options? Yes, first option, option A. Spherically symmetrical. A completely filled D orbitals, that is D10 configuration, is spherically symmetrical. Because all the orbitals are having two electrons in each. So that is said to be as spherically symmetrical. Yes, text me the next question. Question number 18. What is the option given? Yes. Next question number 28. If the atomic weight of an element is 23 times that of lightest element, and it has 11 protons, then it contains. If the atomic weight of an element is 23 times that of the lightest element, and it has 11 protons, then it contains. Yes, what is the lightest element? What is the lightest element among all the elements? Which one is the lightest element? Lightest element is hydrogen, is the lightest element. Hydrogen contain how many number of protons? Hydrogen contain how many number of protons? Correct. Hydrogen is going to contain one proton. So 23 times that of hydrogen. 23 times that of hydrogen means the mass of that X element is equal to 23. The mass of that X element is equal to 23. So here the question given is, if the atomic weight is given. So I'm taking the element X. Atomic weight is given. Atomic weight. Where we have to take the atomic weight? We have to take the atomic weight at which part? Superscript part. So this is the atomic weight. Nothing but which value? Capital A value. Capital A value. And it has 11 protons. 11 protons. 11 protons are indicating which number? Number of protons indicates atomic number. Atomic number is represented by capital Z. Capital Z. So here 11 number of protons are there, means it is the atomic number. Atomic number is indicated by Z. And atomic weight is given 23. That is mass number. So capital A value is equal to 23. Capital Z value is equal to 11. then we can calculate number of neutrons. Just tell me the formula. What is the number of neutrons? What is the formula to calculate the number of neutrons? To calculate the number of neutrons, the formula is A minus Z, mass number minus atomic number. Mass number is equal to 23, atomic number is equal to 11, that is equal to 12. So therefore, what we can write here, number of protons is equal to atomic number. Number of protons is equal to atomic number. Number of electrons is equal to atomic number. Now, the number of neutrons is equal to, first we have to write the formula, mass number minus atomic number, that is equal to 23 minus 11, that is equal to 12. Yes, see the option. What is the question number? Yes, 28. For question number 28, see the option C. Option C, 11 protons, 12 neutrons, and 11 electrons. So option is, for that question, option is C. Yes, text me the next number. Question number 17. In which one of the following pairs of experimental observations and the phenomenon does experimental observations correctly account for the phenomena? So once again the question, in which of the following pairs of experimental observations and phenomena does experimental observations correctly account for the phenomena? Phenomena means it is a statement. Just it is a statement, theoretical statement. And experimental observation is there. So theoretical statement, which is going to be equal to experimental observation, in which case it is correct. Let's check the options once. X-ray spectra, charge on the nucleus, whether it is discovered by X-ray spectra, test, just wait. And second option, alpha particles scattering quantized electron orbit. Alpha particles scattering is going to show that the total mass of the atom is concentrated at the center of the atom only. So it says about the presence of total mass of the atom at the center, that is called as nucleus. So here, statement and experiment. First one is the experiment. Alpha particles scattering, that is the experiment. Quantized electronic orbit, that is the statement. Whether both are matching? Next, say the next option C. Emission spectra. Yes, emission spectra. Line emission spectra of hydrogen atom explains the quantization of energies of electrons. So first one is the experimental observation. Next line is the theoretical statement. So both are correct. So option C. Check the option once. Question number 17. Yes, correct answer. Option C. Yes, did you understand the question? Okay, fine. Yes, what is the next question number? 19. The emission spectrum of hydrogen is found to satisfy the expression for the energy change delta E in joules, such that delta E is equal to 2.18 into 10 to the power of minus 18 into 1 by N1 square minus 1 by N2 square joules, where small n1 is equal to 1, 2, 3 and so on. Small n2 is equal to 2, 3, 4 and so on. The spectral line corresponding to Pascal series. The spectral line corresponds to Pascal series. If you read the textbook, you can understand. The line emission spectrum of hydrogen atom. Once again, the line emission spectrum of hydrogen atom. If you observe the diagram, you can see different group of spectral lines. First one is Lyman series. Second one is Balmer series. Third one is Pascal series. Once again, first one is Lyman series. In the case of Lyman series, N1 is equal to 1. In the case of Balmer series, N1 is equal to 2. In the case of Paschen series, N1 is equal to 3. So here Paschen series is asked. So N1 value starts from 3. N1 value is 3, not starts from. N1 value is 3. N2 value starts from 4, 5, 6, 7, and so on. Yes, N1 value is 3. N2 value starts from 4, 5, 6, and so on. So option is B. Question number 19, option B. Yes, what is the next question number? 23. Question number 23. The compound in which cation is isoelectronic with anion. The compound in which cation is isoelectronic with anion. The compound in which cation is isoelectronic with anion. First of all, what is meant by isoelectronic? What is meant by isoelectronic? Isoelectronic means having same number of electrons. Having same number of electrons is said to be isoelectronic. Yes. Check the options. Yes, where is the question? Okay, question number 23. In my paper, question number it is 23. Yes. Okay. If you go for the option D, K2S is given. Potassium sulfide. K means potassium. Potassium sulfide. The compound is named as potassium sulfide. Here, potassium is known as first A group element. If you see the periodic table, in the next classes, we will discuss the periodic table. In the lower sections also, you know about classification of elements. Potassium belongs to first A group element. Already I explained the electronic configuration of potassium. Potassium valency contain one electron. So potassium is ready to lose one electron. How many potassiums are there? Two potassiums are there. So two potassiums are going to lose two electrons. Total two electrons are going to be lost. Because each potassium is going to lose one electron. Two potassiums are going to lose two electrons. The two electrons are gained by sulfur. S2 minus. 2 minus is called as sulfide ion. Yes, 2 minus ion is called as sulfide ion. K plus ion is called as potassium ion. Yes, what is the atomic number of potassium? Atomic number of potassium is 19. If you check the periodic table, you can find out potassium atomic number is 19. It is going to lose one electron. Plus indicating loss of electron. Potassium is going to lose one electron. Then how many electrons it is going to have? K plus ion is going to have how many electrons? 18 electrons. Sulfur. What is the atomic number of sulfur? Atomic number of sulfur is 16. And it is gained 2 electrons. Sulfur gained 2 electrons. Then sulfur becomes as sulfide ion. So when 2 electrons are gained, plus 2, sulfur atomic number 16, that is 16 electrons are there. Sulfur is going to gain 2 electrons, that is plus 2, that is equal to 18. 18 electrons are there. So in which compound the two elements are going to have same number of electrons? Means in potassium sulfide, potassium ions are having 18 electrons. Sulfur ion is having 18 electrons. So K2S containing the atoms or the ions are said to be isoelectronic. Yes, once check the option. 23. Yes, correct answer. 23, option D. For the question number 23, option is D. Yes, if you understood, please text me the response also. Because I want to know your response. Whenever you are asking the question, after the completion of the answer, you have to give your response. Okay, next question number 19. Question number 19, just now I discussed. You are not watching the video, I think so. Just now I discussed. Yes, text me the next number. Question number 28. Question number 28 is also completed. Question number 28 is also completed in this class itself. Watch the video once again. After I am going to complete this class, I will send the recorded video, then you can watch. Question number 21. Question number 21 is also discussed. Just now I discussed. Question number 6. That means you are not listening to the class. I think so. You are not listening. You are not watching to the video. Huh? Just you are keeping your mobile online and you are watching your TV, something like that. Yes, question number 6. Which of the following are isoelectronic spaces? Question number 6. Which of the following are isoelectronic spaces? Similar concept. Just now I explained the same. Isoelectronic means having same number of electrons. Having same number of electrons. The spaces having same number of electrons are said to be isoelectronic. And if you go for CH3 plus, carbon contains 6 electrons. Hydrogen contain 1 electron. How many hydrogens are there? Carbon containing 6 electrons. Hydrogens contain 1 electron. How many hydrogens are there? 3 hydrogens are there. 3 into 1. Minus 1. Why I am writing minus 1? Because plus is there. Plus indicating loss of 1 electron. Just tell me how many electrons are present in CH3 plus. 3 into 1, 3. 6 plus 3, 9. 9 minus 1. 9 minus 1, 8 electrons. CH3 plus contain 8 electrons. Next one, H3O plus. Yes, once again, 3 into 1. Because 3 hydrogen atoms are there. Each hydrogen atom contains 1 electron plus here, oxygen is there. Right, I am taking 1. Because only 1 oxygen atom is there, that is 1. Oxygen atomic number, 8. Oxygen atomic number is 8. Here again, plus is there. Plus indicating loss of electron. Loss of electron, that is minus 1, that is equal to 3 into 1, 3 plus 8, 11, 11 minus 1, 11 minus 1, 10 electrons. H3O plus contain 10 electrons. And the next one, NH3, one nitrogen is there, nitrogen atomic number 7, that contains 7 electrons, plus 3 hydrogens are there. Hydrogen atomic number 1 that contains 1 electron and it is having no charge. No charge is there. There is no loss of electron. There is no gain of electron. So simply we can calculate. 7 into 1, 7 plus 3 into 1, 3. 7 plus 3. 7 plus 3, 10 electrons. And the next one, CH3 minus. Yes. One carbon is there. That is 1 into 6 because carbon atomic number is 6. The carbon atomic number is 6 plus 3 into, because 3 hydrogens are there, 3 into hydrogen atomic number 1. Here minus charge is given. Minus charge indicating gaining of electron. The minus charge is indicating gaining of electron. Gaining of electron means plus 1. Don't get confused, please. Here minus is given means addition of electron. Here plus is given means removal of electron. Once again. When the plus charge is given, that is indicating removal of electron. When the minus charge is given, that is indicating addition of electron. Yes, 6 into 1, 6 plus 3 plus 1. How many electrons are present here? 10 electrons are present. So what are isoelectronic here? What are isoelectronic here? H3O plus, NH3 and CH3 minus. H3O plus, NH3 and CH3 minus are isoelectronic in nature. CH3 plus means Roman number 1. Sorry. Yes, what we have to take? Roman number 2, Roman number 3, and Roman number 4. These are isoelectronic. Roman number 2, Roman number 3, Roman number 4. Yes, option B. For this question, the option is B. Once check the option. Question number 6. Yes, correct answer. Option B. Yes. Text me your response. Whether the concept is understood. Okay. What is the next question number? What is the next question number? Is there any doubts from this paper? Is there any doubts from this question paper? All the students must give your response, please. All the students, please give your response. Type your response. Don't say no or yes. No doubts, sir. Or there are some doubts, sir. Don't say no. No doubts, sir. Or understood, sir. Okay. Now coming to the material. From your material. In the last class, we are discussing about francium. Let's open your material. Open your material and see the structure of atom. Page number. Okay. Page number 46. Open your material, please. See the page number 46. Page number 46. The penultimate shell of francium. Question number 26. Page number 46. And question number 26. The penultimate shell. The penultimate shell of francium. Francium symbol is Fr. Z means atomic number. Atomic number is given as 87. So we have to write which configuration? Penultimate shell configuration. Penultimate shell means which shell it is? Penultimate shell means n minus 1 shell. N minus 1 shell is called as penultimate shell. I am sharing the screen to you. Yesterday we are discussing about this one, periodic classification of elements. On the screen you can see now, periodic classification of elements. Yes, francium. See this one at the left bottom side, this one, francium. Are you able to see this one? Yes, okay. So francium atomic number is given as 7. It belongs to first A group elements or first group elements. So we have to take atomic number as 87 and we have to fill the electrons in the increasing order of energies of orbitals. Yes, we are going to write the electronic configuration in the increasing order of energies of orbitals. First of all, take the screenshot of this one. Take the screenshot of this concept, francium. Yes, we are going to write the electronic configuration of francium based on Euler diagram. By using Euler diagram, we are going to write the electronic configuration. 1s, Euler diagram. 1s, 2s, 2p, 3s, 3p, 3d, 4s, 4p, 4d, 4f, 5s, 5p, 5d, 5f, 6s, 6p, 6d, 7s, 7p, and 8s. So this is a filling of electrons in the increasing order of energies of orbitals. All of us know. So first we have to take 1s, 2s, 2p. Next it is 3s, 3p. Next it is 4s, 3d, 4p. Next it is 5s, 4d, 5p. Next it is 6s, 4f, 5d, 6p. See here, 6s. After 6s, electron centers into 4f. After 4f, electron centers into 5d. After 5d, electron centers into 6p. After 6p, electron centers into 7s. 7s. Now, fill the electrons. Atomic number. What is the atomic number of francium? What is the atomic number of francium? Atomic number of francium given as 78. On the screen, on the left side, bottom, you can see atomic number of francium is given as 78. We have to fill 78 electrons. 2, 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, 4s2, d orbitals. D orbitals can have maximum of 10 electrons. P orbitals can have maximum of 6 electrons. S orbitals can have maximum of 2 electrons. D orbitals can have maximum of 10 electrons. P orbitals can have maximum of 6 electrons, 2 electrons. F orbitals can have maximum of 14 electrons. D orbitals can have maximum of 10 electrons. P orbitals can have maximum of 6 electrons. Yes, count the number of electrons. 2 plus 2, 4. 4 plus 6, 10. 10 plus 2, 12. 12 plus 6, 18. 18 plus 2, 20. 20 plus 10, 30. 30 plus 6, 36. 36 plus 2, 38. 38 plus 10, 48. 48 plus 6, 54. 54 plus 2, 56. 56 plus 14, 70. 70, 70 plus 10, 80, 80 plus 6, 86. Actually, what is the atomic number of, francium? The francium atomic number is given as 87, 87, not the 78, 87. Francium atomic number is 87. Once again, say this number. The francium atomic number is given as 87. So up to this, how much completed? 86 is completed. So here it is, 87. So, yes, on the screen you can see now. So if you count this one, finally we can write the outer shell electronic configuration is 7s1. So seventh shell is the ultimate shell. Seventh shell is the ultimate shell. What is the penultimate shell? If the seventh shell is the ultimate shell, if the seventh shell is the ultimate shell or valency shell or outermost shell or ultimate shell, sixth shell is the penultimate shell or penultimate shell. Sixth shell is known as the penultimate shell. Sixth shell is now known as the which type of shell? N minus one shell. When the seventh shell is known as the ultimate shell or valency shell or outermost shell or nth shell, then sixth shell is known as the penultimate shell or N minus one shell. Yes, sixth shell. What the sixth shell is containing? 6s2. Say this one. Sixth shell is containing electronic configuration is 6s2, 6p6. Yes, in your material, if you see the option, 6s2, 6p6, where it is present? Option B. 26th question. If you see the option, option is B, 6s2, 6p6. Yes. So if you know this Moeller diagram and filling of electrons by using Afebo principle, Pauli exclusion principle, and Hund's rule, we can write the electronic configuration of any of the element. If the atomic number is given, then we can write the electronic configuration of any of the element. But among the 118 elements, few elements are showing abnormalities. Already we discussed the three elements. One is the chromium, second one is the copper, and third one is the lead, PD. Palladium, not the lead. PB is lead. PB is called as plumbum, that is lead. PD is called as palladium. We discussed about this one, palladium. So palladium is also showing anomalous electronic configuration or abnormal electronic configuration. So about remaining elements, whatever they are going to show the anomalous electronic configuration, we will discuss them in the next chapter, periodic classification of elements. So the time is already completed, but still the Zoom is continuing. I don't know why it is happening from last 2 days. More than 40 minutes, the class is going on. So maybe the Zoom is going to provide extra session. But according to the timetable, we have to follow the 40 minutes time because next class should be conducted soon. So that's why I'm going to end the class. Please, I'm requesting you all, please practice the MCQs from the material. And every day you have to post whatever you are writing in your notes. You have to take a photo and you have to post it to me. Once again, the instruction to all of you, every day you have to practice the MCQs from this chapter at least 10 to 20 questions you have to practice, and you must take a photo and you have to send that photo to my WhatsApp number, and you must send to this number only, don't use other number. You have to send every day whatever the work done by you in the form of one photograph, and particularly to this number only, right? Thank you, my dear students. Thank you one and all, and please watch the recorded videos properly. And already yesterday I sent one recorded video, psi square versus r. It is very important video lecture. Please watch this video lecture, psi square versus r of the orbitals, right? Thank you for watching to the recorded videos, and thank you for your good response. But still some students are not in proper manner. I'm asking you, you have to send the corrected papers, and you have to text your name, group name, and number of marks you must text. But still some students are not doing like that. I am not going to enter your marks. If you are not following the instructions, I am not going to enter your marks. Yes, once again, thank you. Have a nice day.